Hi, this is Kate from Minute Earth.
In the mid-20th century, a standard treatment for severe depression was to attach electrodes to a patient's skull and turn on the juice, running an electrical current through the brain that would cause a brief seizure, a process known as electroshock therapy. It was shockingly brutal, sometimes causing broken bones and temporary short-term memory loss. Eventually, public awareness of these side effects led to growing resistance to electroshock therapy and a steep decline in its use. But the thing was, electroshock did work, alleviating depression in 2/3 of patients, more than responded to drugs. Electrical therapy likely works because depression seems to stem from when the brain's regular electrical signals misfire. Sending a jolt of electricity into the brain to induce a seizure might be like hitting a reset button, so some doctors kept using electroshock despite its bad reputation. But they began targeting the current to one side of the brain to try to reduce effects on memory, and using anesthesia and muscle relaxants to prevent painful convulsions, keeping the good effects while reducing the side effects. Today, the treatment, now called electroconvulsive therapy, still causes headaches and some short-term memory loss, but its success short-circuiting depression has sparked doctors to begin treating other brain illnesses with electricity. For example, abnormal electrical activity in the brains of people with advanced Parkinson's disease immobilizes them and makes their muscles twitch. But sending regular pulses of electricity at the brain regions involved in movement interrupts the misfiring, allowing the patients to move more freely and to experience far fewer tremors. Lots of other brain diseases also involve electrical signaling gone haywire, so electrical therapies may be able to benefit a lot more people in the future. That is, assuming research keeps on charging ahead. Thanks for watching Minute Earth. If you love what we do, you can support us by going to patreon.com/minuteearth and pledging as little as $1 per episode. If you'd rather, you can also support us right here on YouTube. Just click the sponsor button below the video to sign up. Your support means we can spend more time exploring and explaining everything from disease therapies to plant strategies to animal fallacies. Thanks!